This should look somewhat familiar, but what we're going to do is move these patterns into Photoshop and change them so they're almost unrecognizable. So first thing is notice that the centers are already highlighted. I figured out something with the attributes, you know, the show center right here. A way for us to simplify the process. But then working with this, I did a couple other things different. I drew out some guides. Let's come back down here, make this a little smaller so we can see what's going on. These guides are exactly in the center, and you need to go back and, if you haven't done those guides, make these so they're dead on in the center. That's critical that they're perfect because of the registration in Photoshop. But then again, I thought of something else which may be a workaround and help us do something a little different. But for right now, that's important. And then once we make the pattern, we use the move command. And again, if you don't remember how to do that, you need to go back to those patterns because I don't want to be teaching the same thing over and over and over. Okay, it's under transform and move. And notice that the registration is perfect right here on this point. This is for one of them, and then I did the pattern. I registered it right here on this point, which is dead center. If I zoom out a little bit, dead center in that shape that defines our pattern. Remember this shape? Command zero. This guy back here, we'll turn these two off. So that's the Illustrator half. Now let's jump over to Photoshop and look at the Photoshop half. Now there's a gotcha. When you move patterns to Photoshop, I don't know if you can see these lines that pop up. And sometimes there are these artifacts when you work with patterns and you're moving from Illustrator to Photoshop. And sometimes these are really disappointing. And other times they're actually something we can use to play with the geometry. So it's not necessarily a bad thing. There's one of the two. And here's the other one where the lines are far more pronounced and regular. And again, something we can possibly use. Let me just show you, if I hold down Option and click on that eyeball, this pattern can turn into this. And I can take it further, but I'm going to hold off on that. That's one of them, and I'm going to switch over to this one and hold down Option, click on that eyeball. But notice, it's the exact same shape in Illustrator, and we just have a few layers here. That's turning this right here into this in this Photoshop document and jumping over here and turning this pattern into this. So I hope you can see that this is just a taste of what you can do. There are so many different things that you can do with Photoshop without pushing it into the ugly zone, you know, the over-processed. There's a happy medium here that you have to try to find where the geometry holds up and is still recognizable to a degree and becomes visually, aesthetically pleasing rather than completely blown out and, you know, over-processed. So this is going to be a matter of opinion in the Mac Lab, what you and I think looks great. But the important thing is you learn these steps. You learn how to move things from Illustrator to Photoshop and then process them intelligently. So we're going to come back and I'm going to walk you through some of these steps. And this is the beginning of what I call a generative processing in Photoshop. It's a way to nudge imagery out of geometry in Photoshop. And this is kind of cool. Something Whether I invent it or not, that's of a question. But working independently, I stumbled on these things and the steps I'm going to share with you.